today we're going to talk about how to deal with only having one port for two stepper motors on the Z-axis. Now, I prepared a little bit of the board in advance to shorten the tutorial. Basically, these jumpers, when they arrive, are on these two pins instead of these three. So, as you can see, you only need three pins that are jumped, and it's going to be MS0, 1, and 2. So, all the other ones will be the same, but for the Z-axis, I pre-prepared this. So, on the big tree, SKR, what we're going to do is we're going to create a parallel port. So this is the actual parallel port breakout so that you can do two steppers on one axis. So to connect it, you're going to take the notch connector and you're going to push it in like so, and then you're going to place the jumper here to give you two ports. Now, to place this on, we know the enable pin is here based on my previous tutorials for the A4988 and the DRV8825. I go into extreme detail on how to explain that. But all we care about right now is the enable pin right here on the A4988 and the enable pin here so we can orient it correctly. So we're gonna place the pins over here and push it down. And that's how we have that set up. So next we're going to take the connector from the motor that's notched as well and connect it like so. And then finally we're going to take the other motor and do the same. Now to prepare it, we obviously have to load the Marlin firmware. So you're going to connect the big end to the SKR version 1.3, and the small end is going to be connected to the computer. And you want to make sure that you have the TF drive connected to your board so it acts like a USB. Okay, to start with, we can see that the USB drive is showing up for the SKR version 1.3. And we have a file in here called firmware.cur. Now, this is our current firmware. So keep in mind the date and time that's right here, because in a moment that will change. We're going to go over to Atom. And this has PlatformIO. So right now what we want to do is, if you haven't done it already, you're going to unzip your Marlin firmware to a folder. And then what you'll do is open up your whole Marlin firmware in Atom with PlatformIO. Next, what we want to do is we want to go to the Marlin folder, then the source folder, then the core folder, then boards.h, and open that up. And we're going to do a search on SKR. And the board that we're looking for is board_bigtree_SKR_V1_3. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to close out of boards.h. And we're going to open up configuration.h. Inside here, we're going to do a search on motherboard. And we're going to highlight board_ramps_14_EFB. And we're going to paste what we just copied. Then we're going to scroll up here, and where it says serial port 0, we need to change that to -1 because 0 will not work. And this is the configuration used for the SKR version 1.3. Next, we're going to search on A4988. And as you can see, all of our steppers are here, but they're commented out. Normally, they're default A4988, but for the example, I'm going to show you how to enable them so that you can possibly change them if you have a different stepper driver. So you're going to remove the comments for the X, the Y, the Z, and we'll do E0. Now, if you had a different stepper driver, you can always copy it from here and then paste it for what you're using. But in this case, we're using the A4988, so we're all set. Next, we have to check on our steps. So I'm going to do a search on max underscore. And what we're looking for is default access steps per unit. Now our x-axis is 4,000, which is default for the A4988. So we don't have to do anything there. But if it was a different stepper driver, like the DRV8825, which has double the stepping capacity of the A4988, being 1/16th of a step for the A4988, the DRV has 1/32nd of a step. So you would double this if you're using that stepper driver. But in this case, we're not going to worry about that. So next we have to go to PlatformIO.ini and open that up. And because our default environment is set to the Mega 18 Mega 2560 chipset, we need to change that to the chipset that we're actually working with. In this case, we're using the LPC 1768, so we're going to copy that, and the name of the chipset is the ARM Cortex M3. So we're going to scroll back up to default environment for the Mega 2560, and we're going to paste it right here. So that's all we have to do to set it up. Next, to load the firmware, we're going to press the upload button, which will compile our changes and upload them to the SKR version 1.3's USB drive. Okay, now that the compilation has finished and uploaded to the drive for our USB drive for the SKR version 1.3, you can see there's a new file called firmware.bin. Now, take a close look at the time here and the time here, because hopefully if it works, it should copy the time to firmware.cur, meaning that it's updated. But we can also check over here and see that it compiled, at least by going to toggle build panel in PlatformIO on Atom, which it has. So I'm going to toggle that back. I'm going to go back to the actual USB drive and disconnect it, then reconnect it to see if it updates. So, as you can see, it's updated with the current time, or near the current time, of the finish file compilation. Okay, off camera I connected the power supply and I'm gonna plug it in a moment, so we're gonna be all set in 2 seconds to energize it. So now that it's energized, you don't want to touch the board because you don't want to damage it or yourself, because it has live voltage running through it. Okay, we're in the Pronterface folder. I'm gonna open up Pronterface. I'm going to connect to the SKR version 1.3, and as you can see, it says connecting, and now it says printer is online, so we can always double check the firmware by going M115 and pressing enter. And as you can see, it says bug fix 2.0.x, so it looks like it uploaded. So now I'm going to move the Z axis 1 millimeter and we'll see what happens. So here we go. Okay, now we're going to try 10 millimeters. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.